गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, जस्ट आफ्टर द कॉम्प्लीशन ऑफ द चैप्टर सैचुरेटेड हाइड्रोकार्बन दैट इज एल्केन, नेक्स्ट स्विच ओवर टू नेक्स्ट चैप्टर दैट इज अनसैचुरेटेड हाइड्रोकार्बन। इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ टू सब चैप्टर, वन इज एल्कीन्स एंड वन इज एल्काइन्स। लेट अस डिस्कस वन बाय वन। Today, first we discuss alkene. So, in the first class of this chapter, I will try to complete the introduction part, the nomenclature, the general method of preparation, and the physical property. So let us start one by one. We know saturated hydrocarbon, otherwise known as paraffin. The Greek word para means little, affin means affinity. That means normally alkenes have little tendency for reacting. That means they are generally stable at room temperature. On the other hand, alkene, unsaturated hydrocarbons, otherwise known as olefins, means oil forming liquid. Otherwise it is known as olefins. And the alkene is represented by the formula CnH2n, where n starts with 2, 3, 4 dot dot dot. The first member of this family, that is CH2 double bond CH2, that is C2H4, its common name, is known as ethylene. IUPAC name is known as ethene, where carbon atom undergoes sp2 hybridization, that is planar geometry, bond angle is 120 degree. Its IUPAC name, normally its IUPAC name is alkene, alkene minus e r e n e, alkene. First member, I repeat again, first member ethene, next propene, butene, pentene, like this one. Next, switch over to the isomerism. Nomenclature part already completed. Next, switch over to isomerism. In a previous class, already complete. Isomerism is of two type. One is structural isomerism and one is stereoisomerism. Structural isomerism already completed. Now discuss stereoisomerism. What do you mean by stereoisomerism? That means when the same molecular formula represent two or more structure. When the same molecular formula represent two or more structure, which differ in the arrangement of atom or group in space. In the previous class already used this word, that is known as partial arrangement. Arrangement of atom or group in space, then each structure is known as others stereoisomers, and the phenomenon is known as stereoisomerism. It is again divided into three sub part. One is geometrical isomerism, one is optical isomerism, and one is conformational isomerism. Here we focus to geometrical isomerism. What do we know geometrical isomerism? Similar specific line is there, that is when the same molecular formula represent two or more structure which differ in the spatial arrangement of atom or group around the carbon-carbon multiple bond, that is a double bond, then each structure is known as others geometrical isomer, and the phenomenon is known as geometrical isomerism. So generally there are two conditions necessary for a compound to exhibit the geometrical isomerism. One is that compound must contain carbon-carbon double bond. And second thing, the atoms attached to the carbon atom of the multiple bonded must be different one. Then only the compound exhibit geometrical isomerism. I repeat again, that compound must contain carbon-carbon double bond. And second point, the atom or groups attached to carbon atom must be different. Then in this arrangement, two cases arises. One is when same group, same side, that is known as cis form or cis isomer, CIS, and another one is same group in opposite side, that is known as trans form or trans isomer. For example, mark that I select one, that is but2ene. Its formula CH3CH double bond CH single bond CH3. This can be rewrite like this one. Mark that CH3H CH3H, or another way it may also be represented like this. Mark that same formula, but only arrangement of atom groups in space around the carbon-carbon double bond is different. Mark that if we think about same group, same side, it is known as cis but 2ene. Mark that same group in opposite side, then known as trans but 2ene. Okay, so many other examples are there. So first, better we write the definition of stereoisomer, stereoisomerism. Next, we write the definition of geometrical isomerism. Next, we proceed one by one. First, note down definition of stereoisomerism. What do you mean by stereoisomerism? Note down. First one is stereoisomerism. I repeat again, when the same molecular formula represent two or more structure which differ in spatial arrangement, arrangement of atom in space. Okay, note down. When the same molecular formula, when the same molecular formula represents two or more compound which, when the same molecular formula represent two or more compound which differ in spatial arrangement of atoms or groups, then each structure, each compound is known as stereoisomer, and the phenomenon is known as stereoisomerism. Okay, it has three sub unit. One is geometrical isomerism, one is optical isomerism, and one is conformational isomerism. In this chapter, we focus to geometrical isomerism. Next, give the heading geometrical isomerism. Similar statement, no down. When the same molecular formula, when the same molecular formula represents two or more structure which differ in the spatial arrangement of atoms or groups, spatial arrangement of atoms or groups around carbon-carbon double bond then each structure is known as geometrical isomer and the phenomenon is known as geometrical isomerism. Okay, then we represent some example one by one. Next, note down, what are the condition for the geometrical isomerism? Note down, condition for geometrical isomerism. I already discussed, that means two points are there. Note down, point one. The species must contain carbon-carbon double bond that compound must contain a carbon-carbon double bond, okay? And point two, note down. The two atoms or groups that attach to carbon-carbon double bond must be different. Okay, next let us consider few examples. For example, first one, but2ene, formula is CH3, CH, double bond CH, CH3. So two possibilities there. One is a cis form, one is a trans form. Before writing structure, note down, when the same group present in same side, then when the same group present in the same side, then they are known as cis isomer, and when the same group present in opposite direction are known as transisomer. Two terms is there. One is known as cisisomer and one is known as transisomer. For example, taking but2n, note down. It is one arrangement. And it is one arrangement. Mark that. Same group, same side. Same group, same side. It is known as a cis. But2en. Same group, opposite side. Then it is known as trans. But2en. Any doubt? No doubt. Good. Next. Switch over to some other examples. Mark that. Hex 3en. Hexen 3en. Mark that. For this also, two type of arrangement are there. One is known as cisisomer, and one is known as transisomer. So two structure. Second example, that is hex 3en. Formula CH3, CH2. CH, CH2, CH3. Okay, so two possibilities are there. Mark that. CC double bond. Here is H. Here is CH3, CH2. Here is CH2, CH3. Here is H. Mark that. Same group, same side. Same group, same side. It is known as a cis. Hex 3n, and another one is CH3, CH2. H, CH2, CH3. Mark that. Same group in opposite side. It is known as trans hex 3n. Okay, so you have to another example. 1,2-dichloroethene. 1,2-dichloroethene. Formula CH2Cl double bond CH2Cl. For this one, two possibilities are there. Mark that. Carbon carbon double bond. HCl, HCl, and another one HCl, CLH. Mark that. Same group, same side. Same group, opposite side. Okay, so its name is cis 1,2-dichloroethene. Its name is trans 1,2-dichloroethene. Okay, these are some few examples relating to geometrical isomerism. Next, switch over to the general method of preparation. Next, we discuss the general method of preparation of Alkene. There are generally 4 to 5 methods are there. That is, one is from alkyl halide, one is from vicinal dihalide, one is from alcohol, and one is from sodium or potassium salt of dicarboxylic acid. Let us discuss one by one. First one is general methods of preparation of alkene. First one, from alkyl halide by dehydrohalogenation. Mark that. What is the principle? Principle is known as dehydrohalogenation, the process of removal of hydrogen and halogen from alkyl halide. So what is the principle? What is the statement? When alkyl halide heated with alcoholic potash, potash means potassium hydroxide. Okay, I repeat again. When alkyl halide is heated with alcoholic solution of potash, then resulting the formation of an alkene. Okay, note down the statement. When an alkyl halide is heated with an alcoholic solution of potassium hydroxide, alcoholic solution of potassium hydroxide, an alkene is formed. And remember that this process is known as dehydrohalogenation, removal of hydrogen as well as removal of halogen. Mark that. So it will example. For example, CH3CH2Br plus KOH LC, LC means shortcut of alcoholic. What happened? Mark that. Removal of halogen. Removal of halogen, that is KBr plus removal of hydrogen. Mark that. From this carbon atom, halogen removed. From nearest carbon atom, hydrogen removed. That is H2O. What is left? That is CH2, double bond CH2. Its name is ethylene. Its name is ethyl bromide. Okay. Let us select another example. It is example one. Another example, that is CH3CHBrCH3 plus KOHLC heat. Similar statement, its name is known as isopropyl, isopropyl bromide. Mark that. What happened here? Here is halogen is removed and hydrogen is removed. Mark that. What is left? CH3CH double bond CH2 plus KBr plus H2. Its name is propene. Any doubt? No doubt. Good. Next one is, if we select such type of alkyl halide, mark that. Next, another one example, that if two possibilities are there, same dehydrohalogenation is there, but two different type of alkene is there, then among them, one is treated as the major product, while another is treated as the minor product and decided by set Jeff rule. Very, very important one. Students, remember, set Jeff rule. What is that rule? This rule said that when an alkyl halide undergoes dehydrohalogenation, resulting in the formation of an alkene, then that alkene is the major product. That alkene is the stable product, which is highly alkylated. Okay? Mark that. So before going to the example, it is necessary to note down the set Jeff rule. First we note down the rule, then we give one example. Redon, that is set Jeff rule. What is the rule? Note down. When an alkyl halide undergoes dehydrohalogenation, resulting in the formation of dehydrohalogenation, resulting in the formation of an alkene, then that one is the major product. That one is the major product, or you may write stable product which is highly alkylated. What do you mean by highly alkylated? Let us go through one example. Mark that. CH3, for example, CH3, CHBr, CH2, CH3, plus KOH, ALC, heat. Then mark that. One halogen is replaced. Your halogen is replaced. Then nearest two possibilities are there. It is nearest carbon, alpha carbon, is nearest alpha carbon. One possibility, here one alpha is removed. Another possibility, here one is removed. So mark that. Two possibilities there. One is CH3, CH, double bond CH, one CH3. One is CH2, CH, CH2, CH3. Here byproduct KBr and H2. Okay. Its name is but2ene. Its name is but1ene. Mark that. After the removal of halogen, one the chance right hand side alpha removed. So CH3, CH double bond CH. Case 2 is left side alpha H removed. So this one. And here we observed that it is the CCH, CH double bond. So one, there is H replaced by alkyl group. Here one H replaced by alkyl group. Two alkylation is there. Here carbon-carbon double bond. One side of the carbon 2H is there. No alkylation. No H replaced by the alkyl group. While one side H is there, one side ethyl group is there. Only one alkylation is there. Since major is here, so it is known as major product. And it is known as minor product. Okay, any doubt? What do you mean by higher number of alkylation? That means it is alkene, simplest alkene, 4H is there, If number of H, higher the number of H replaced by alkyl group, then you know as higher is the alkylation and higher is the stability. Okay, so here two alkyl group is there, but here one side no alkyl group, one side only one alkyl group. So it is known as a byproduct or minor product, and it is known as a main product or major product. Okay, it is all about the first method. Then switch over to the second method, that is from vicinal dihalide. So dihalide means two halogen are there. Then question arises, the two halogen attached to one carbon atom or two halogen atom attached to nearby carbon atom, neighboring carbon atom. Then when the case when two halogen atom attached to one carbon atom, then it is known as geminal dihalide. On the other hand, when the two halogen atom attached to nearby carbon atom, neighboring carbon atom, nearest carbon atom, then it is known as a vicinal dihalide. So now we select from vicinal dihalide. Next method, from vicinal dihalide. What is the statement? When the vicinal dihalide heated with zinc metal, then what happened? Undergoes a dehalogenation. In previous case, dehydrohalogenation. Now is a dehalogenation, resulting in the formation of an alkene. Okay, note down the first statement. When vicinal dihalide is heated with zinc metal, when vicinal dihalide heated with zinc metal undergoes dehalogenation, resulting in the formation of an alkene. Okay, for example, mark that CH2Br heated with zinc metal, what is its name? 1,2 dibromo ethane. On heating, what happened? Zinc valency 2, so what happened? CH2 double bond CH2 plus ZnBr2, its name is ethylene. As only halogen is removed, so this process is known as dehalogenation. Okay, move to third method, that is from alcohol. Next method, that is third method, is from alcohol. So this one again contain 2 bit by the heating with alumina, and bit 2 by heating with concentrated sulfuric acid. So let us discuss one by one. So bit 1, by heating with alumina. Alumina, you know the formula, that is Al2O3. When alcohol is heated with alumina at 620 Kelvin, what happened? Undergoes a dehydration, means removal of water, resulting in the formation of an alkene. Okay, note down the statement. When an alcohol is heated with alumina at 623 Kelvin. Undergoes dehydration forming an alkene. Okay, let us select one example. For example, CH3 CH2OH when heated with Al2O3 623 Kelvin, what happened? From this carbon OH, from this carbon H is removed. What is the product? CH2 double bond CH2, byproduct is H2O. You may write here plus H2O or above below arrow mark, you may write minus H2O. Its name is ethylene. Its name is ethyl alcohol or primary alcohol. Okay. Next we go to B2, that is by heating with concentrated sulfuric acid. We know that is concentrated sulfuric acid, also known as a dehydrating agent. So when different types of alcohol, that is primary alcohol, secondary alcohol, tertiary alcohol, 1 degree, 2 degree, 3 degree alcohol, heated with sulfuric acid, concentrated sulfuric acid, in each step resulting the formation of dehydration, resulting the formation of an alkene. Okay, so first write the statement. When an alcohol is heated with concentrated sulfuric acid, an alkene is formed. So just now we discuss about, that is there are three types of alcohols are there, that is 1 degree alcohol or a primary alcohol, next 2 degree alcohol or secondary alcohol, next 3 degree alcohol or tertiary alcohol. Again question arises, what do you mean by primary, secondary, tertiary? That means if the alcohol group, functional group attached to one primary carbon atom, then it is known as primary alcohol. On the other hand, if it is attached to secondary carbon, then known as secondary alcohol. Or similarly, if it is attached to tertiary carbon, then it is known as tertiary alcohol. So let us write one on example relating to it. First one is primary alcohol, that is CH3CH2OH. Mark that here the functional group is OH, and this OH attached to this carbon atom, and this carbon atom is a primary carbon, because this carbon atom left, right, top, bottom only attached to only one carbon, so it is known as a primary carbon atom or 1 degree carbon atom, and the alcohol group attached to 1 degree carbon is known as a primary alcohol. Okay, its name is ethyl alcohol or 1 degree alcohol. When heated with 95% H2SO4 at 443 Kelvin, then dehydration going on, resulting the formation of an alkene. Its name is ethylene. Okay, similarly, if we select another example, that is a 2 degree alcohol. Mark that this alcohol group attached to this carbon, and it is a 2 degree, because this carbon attached to two other carbon. Its name is isopropyl alcohol. It is known as a 2 degree. When it is heated to 60% sulfuric acid and at 373 Kelvin, mark that one OH and one H removed, resulting the formation of CH3CH double bond CH2 plus water. Its name is propene. Okay, similarly select another example, that is CH3 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 COH. Mark that it is the alcohol attached to this carbon atom and it is known as 3 degree because this carbon atom directly attached to 3 other carbon atom. Okay, its name is tot butyl alcohol or it is known as 3 degree. When it had to 30% sulfuric acid at 363 Kelvin. Mark that here one OH, here H is removed, resulting in the formation of an alkene plus water. So what is the IPSC name? Select the mention 1, 2, 3 or 1, 2, 3 as the functional group here, numbering from this 1, 2, 3, two position branching. Its name is 2-methyl propene. These are some examples of dehydration of alcohol. In addition to this, another one special case also there. That means if excess of alcohol is there, then here excess of sulfuric acid and high temperature. If excess of alcohol at a low temperature is there, same process going on, dehydration going on, but resulting in the formation of an ether. So it is a very, very important question. Students, remember that. Read the question and mark that what is the temperature. If it is a high temperature, then alkene is formed. On the other hand, if it is low temperature, then ether is formed. So let us select some examples. For example, note down CH3, CH2, OH. It is concentrated sulfuric acid at 413 Kelvin. Previous one is 443 Kelvin. Here is 413 Kelvin. If you mark that it is 413 Kelvin, then here excess of alcohol, that means CH3, CH2, OH plus CH3, CH2, OH concentrated sulfuric acid at 413 Kelvin. What happened? Water is removed, but the product is an ether. It is ethyl, diethyl ether. Common name is diethyl ether, or IPSC name is alkoxy alkane, ethoxy ethane. Okay, move to next method, that is from alkyne. So go to fourth method, that is known as alkyne. Under this heading also two sub-point is there. One is by taking linear catalyst, that is palladium supported over barium sulfate, and one is by taking sodium in presence of liquid ammonia. So if we select palladium supported barium sulfate, then cis isomer is formed. If we select sodium in presence of liquid ammonia, then trans isomer is formed. Okay, in both the cases we shift to from alkyne by reduction. Okay, move to fourth method, from alkynes by reduction. Okay, note down bit one, by using linear catalyst. What is that one? That is palladium supported over barium sulfate. Okay, let us select one example, that is CH3, that is but 2YNE. Reduction means addition of hydrogen in presence of palladium supported over barium sulfate. One is transport here, one is transport here, resulting in the formation of CH3H, CH3H, that is but cis but 2-ene, resulting in the formation of cis isomer. Okay, so note down the statement. When ब्यूट टू वाई एन अंडरगोज रिडक्शन इन प्रेजेंस ऑफ अंडरगोज रिडक्शन इन प्रेजेंस ऑफ लिनर कैटलिस्ट सीस ब्यूट टू एन इज फॉर्म ओके गुड ऑन द अदर हैंड बी टू दैट इज बाय यूजिंग सोडियम इन प्रेजेंस ऑफ लिक्विड अमोनिया नो डाउन व्हेन ब्यूट टू वाई एन ई अंडरगोज रिडक्शन इन प्रेजेंस ऑफ सोडियम स्लैश लिक्विड अमोनिया ट्रांस ब्यूट टू एन ई इज फॉर्म इन केस ऑफ पैलेडियम सपोर्ट ओवर बेरियम सल्फेट सीस आइसोमर इज फॉर्म बट इन केस ऑफ सोडियम स्लैश अमोनिया देन ट्रांस आइसोमर इज फॉर्म फॉर एग्जांपल नोट ऑन द इक्वेशन सेम इक्वेशन ओनली चेंज द कैटलिस्ट Mark that here is sodium slash liquid ammonia. What is the product? CH3H double bond HCH3 known as trans but to en. Its name is but to yn. Okay, it is all about. The method of preparation of alkene. Next class, we will go to the physical and chemical property of alkene.